morning, Greater Belle Zion. How's everybody doing this morning? God has blessed us one more time. He's a mighty good God. Hey. God is good. It's worth saying over and over again, amen. And many of us have thought we would be preparing and getting water and getting all that stuff, but how many know that God is an awesome God? He's looking out for us. He cares for us. He knows exactly what we need. We are in prayer for our brothers and sisters that are on the Gulf Coast. We don't know where it hits, but we know wherever it hits, God is still in control. Good God. How many know it's service time? We're going to praise Him this morning. Amen. God is so good. Just be prayerful as we work out the audio.
The Bluetooth device is ready to pair.
Scripture and continue to pray, church, as we work out the glitches in our audio this morning.
Good morning, church family. Our scripture reading this morning is a familiar one to the Bible study group. It comes from the book of James, chapter 1, and I will be reading verses 2 through 12. Again, that's the book of James, chapter 1. Starting at verse 2. I will be reading from the New American Standard, and it reads this way. Consider it all joy, my brethren, when you encounter various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces endurance. And let endurance have its perfect result, so that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. But if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives it to all generously and without reproach, and it will be given to him. But he who must ask in faith without any doubting, for the one who doubts is like a surf of the sea driven and tossed by the wind. For that man ought not to expect that he will receive anything from the Lord. Being a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. But the brother of humble circumstances is to glory in his high position, and the rich man is to glory in his humiliation, because like flowering grass, he will pass away. For the sun rises with the scorching wind and withers the grass, and its flowers fall off, and the beauty of its appearance is destroyed. So too, the rich man, in the midst of his pursuits, will fade away. Blessed is a man who perseveres under trial. For once he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life which the Lord has promised to those who love him. I read for your spiritual nourishment and understanding, James chapter 1, verses 2 through 12. May the Lord add his blessings to the reading, hearing, and doing of his holy word. Now let us go to the Lord in prayer. O good and gracious God, once again we come before you so thankful for all that you have done for us. To the Lord, we come with reverence and humility, acknowledging that all of our blessings flow from you. To the Lord, we're thankful for this glorious Sunday morning. We're thankful for all the saints of Greater Belle Zion and our guests, the Lord, who have gathered here. These faithful souls, the Lord, we're so thankful. And we ask for your blessings on them and every home that they represent. But to the Lord, as we stand here, we're mindful that there are some of our saints that are sick and shut in, dear Lord, and we just pray for some restoration of their strength. In the meantime, dear Lord, we pray for you strengthening them as they go through their various infirmities. Dear Lord, we pray for all of those who are grieving, dear Lord, those who have lost a loved one, dear Lord, whether it be among our church family or elsewhere in this land or around the world. We know that these are difficult times with this pandemic, and dear Lord, we know that it is, there are tough days ahead, and we just pray that you grant them peace, strength, peace, comfort, and strength as they go through these trying times. Dear Lord, we pray for those who are affected in other ways by the pandemic, those who just are dealing with the burdens and trials and tribulations of life. We pray, dear Lord, that you will grant them strength and peace. Dear Lord, we continue to pray for our children. Bless them, dear Lord. Keep them along the path of righteousness. Dear Lord, we pray for our pastor, the angel of this church, dear Lord, the leader of this flock. We pray that you will continue to grant him the wisdom, knowledge, and the endurance necessary to take us to higher heights. Dear Lord, we renew our petition, dear Lord, that you intercede on our behalf, dear Lord, with the Texas City Independent School District, the Board of Trustees, dear Lord, so that that they will make a way so that we can obtain the land we need, dear Lord, to build the tabernacle that is befitting of you, dear Lord. Dear Lord, above all, we pray for that we give thanks, dear Lord, for Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who came. He taught us the right way to live, dear Lord. He died, he was buried, and he has risen, dear Lord, to sit at your right hand, interceding on our behalf. And for that, we are forever thankful. And it's in his precious name that we give thanks and we ask it all. Amen.
As we move further on with our service, we know we serve a good God, we serve a mighty God, and he's worthy to be praised. Our God is great and worthy to be praised. Amen. Bear with us as we go this week, and we're still in the midst of the pandemic. We're still so many things that we could say, but there's far more many things that we could say about God's grace, about God's mercies, about God's blessings. That we just praise him for his mighty acts. We praise him for the wonderful things that he has done. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings. Thank you for the sunshine. Lord, we thank you for the rain. We thank you for everything. We thank you for health and strength. We thank you for our loved ones. Lord, we thank you for the ability to come out under this tree. Father God, we just thank you. Because you're such an awesome God. You're a great God. The song says, the splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light and darkness, tries to hide and trembles at his voice. But we know he's a mighty good God. We know that age to age he stands, and time is in his hand. From the beginning and the end, we know him to be the Alpha and Omega. He's a Godhead, three in one. He's a Father, he's a Spirit, and he's a Son. The Lion and the Lamb. Age to age. And he's a mighty good God. We continue to serve him every day, just knowing that he's a keeper He's a deliverer, whatever you need him to be this morning. He's ready to be that for you. Amen. We are up to our offering time. We are up to our announcement time. And we do have an announcement before we further the service. It says a big thank you. 1 Corinthians 13 and 4 says love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous. It does not brag, and it is not proud. It says to the Bellzion family and friends, thank you for sharing the love on yesterday and for sharing and showing out. Thank you, and God bless you. This is the birthday girl, Sister Doris Urban. Amen.
We are up to our giving time. This is a special time for us because it allows us to praise God through giving of the substance that he has so freely given to us. There are many different ways that you can give as the officers are coming around. Also, you can give through our Cash App. Cash App is new, GBZ 1885. New GBZ 1885. We thank God for those of you that's using the new technology through our Cash App. We do receive it, and it is turned in and counted for. Amen. So without further ado, we're going to further the service as Deacon Terrell comes.
Good
Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, creator and sustainer of earth, we come this morning, Heavenly Father, as humble as we know how. We have praise on our lips. We have thanksgiving in our hearts. Thanking you, Heavenly Father, for the goodness and the mercy you show toward us. Thanking you for opportunity this morning, Heavenly Father, for the ability to gather and praise your name at all times. We thank you for the relationship, for you are our God and we're your people. We thank you most of all for our once crucified but resurrected Savior, who is Christ Jesus, the one who, while we were yet in sin, died for us. We ask you to bless these offerings that's being lifted in your namesake. It is our desire that it be used to further the gospel cause on earth. We thank you for the gifts. We thank you for the givers. We ask you to bless those who had the desire to give but had not. We pray for increase in their lives. We pray for increase in faith, increase in favor, and even finances, Father. Not that we be glorified, but you and you alone. Now, in the precious, powerful, matchless name of Jesus Christ our Lord, we offer thanks through this prayer. Amen.
Good morning, DBZ family. God is an awesome God. And he's had allowed us to see another brand new day, one that we've never seen before,
and one we'll never see again.
So give praises to God Almighty for waking me up this morning in considerable portion of light, health, and strength, and in our right minds. Amen. We just thank you for being here today. God has given us another beautiful day. As Brother Zai has already said, it is so amazing how God can work. It's truly amazing grace to give us this window of opportunity to lift up and praise his holy name. I just thank God for his mercy and his grace. Without it, none of us would be here. We need to praise God right about that, because he doesn't have to praise us. He doesn't have to do what we think he needs to do to us. He's just so gracious in his mercy and grace. We thank God for that. Again, I want to, before I start, thank you so much for your gifts for our 18th anniversary. We thank you so much for what you did for us and my family. We thank God for you. We love you, Belzine, and that's nothing you can do about it. We're just going to love you. Amen. To all our visitors, we thank God for you being here today. I've got a brief message, and I was trying to think how I might phrase this or come at this. But there are some strong women in the Bible. There are some very strong and courageous women. We know about Jochebed, and we know about a different thing, Lydia and some of the others. We know about Moses' wife. But the thing is that there are some strong women in the Bible. And if you noticed on last week, we brought you a verse about the widow from Nain. She was responsible for her son, and God showed up just at the right time. Today, we want you to come and go with us to the book of Matthew, the 15th chapter, and let's read about, or let's pray about, or let's discuss a Canaanite woman who came to Jesus and asked for help. Matthew 15, and start about that 21st verse. Matthew 15, the 21st verse, signified by your horn blowing when you reach that passage of scripture. I'm reading from the King James, and reading about that deep portion of that 21st verse. This woman saying, "Have mercy on me, O Lord. Have mercy on me, O Lord." I'd like to talk to you from this thought. Lord, I'll just be happy with the crumbs. Lord, I'll just be happy with the crumbs. In this 15th chapter of our Lord's Gospel according to Matthew, we see where Jesus is teaching. He's healing all that was brought to him. He's teaching his disciples, and he's also teaching the Jews about healing, of seeing the master doctor and the master teacher at work within the same setting. And so he goes on and he heals different people. It's in the text, you can read it. And then he comes to the disciples and the Jews, and they're talking about what defileth the man, and Jesus tells them, no, it's really not, paraphrasing, it's not what goes in a man that follows them, it's what comes out. And then he departed and went into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And there, behold, a woman of Canaanite origin came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord. Here is a Canaanite woman. Let me see if I can break this down for you. A Canaanite woman really had no business with Jesus. When I say business, that means talking and bringing up different conversation. Remember the woman at the well in John 4? That was a Canaanite woman. She was also a adulterous woman, but guess what? Jesus had time for her. And I want to let you know that no matter who you are, where you came from, Jesus has time for you. He has time for your family. And here she meets him. Look at this tenacity of this woman. Knowing that she is a Gentile, and normally the Jews refer to Gentiles as dogs, literal dogs. And so that was a derogatory statement that they were using to bring down, so to speak, those who they said didn't deserve to be around them. So really a Jew didn't have anything to do with a Gentile. You can see it all the way through. Paul was teaching that we all in the same clutch. We all made from the same pattern. So why, rather than help one another, do as Christians we look down upon one another? We all on the same road. We all supposed to be serving the same Lord. And so here it is, she cried unto him, have mercy on me, Lord, thou son of David, which lets me know that even as a Gentile woman, she has heard about the healing power of Jesus Christ. She knows that he is of the lineage of Jesus Christ. She says, look, David came through 42 generations. I know and heard about how you heal folk, how you deal with folk. Let me tell you something right here. You can remember this. Don't ever let anybody define you on what they say you ought to be or what you ought to do. Because here in the text, the very disciples asked Jesus to send the woman away. Isn't that amazing how church folk, sometimes church folk will get in the way of your blessing. They'll tell you, oh, we don't shout like that, or we don't need to praise God like that, or it don't take all of that. Don't let anybody deter you from coming to Jesus. Right here in our text, this woman was determined to get help for her daughter, who was, it says, was terribly vexed with an evil spirit. And mothers will go the limit for their children. Moses' mother, at the last minute, put him in the Nile River in a little basket and put him in the flags. And we have to understand that mothers will always go to, no matter what you've done, no matter how they say they're going to give you up to the Lord, which they do, guess what? They still love you. And this woman loved her daughter so much that she approached Jesus, being a Gentile. Here again, no matter who you are, no matter what you've done in life, guess what? Jesus has room for you. And it shows in this text that, look at Jesus. Jesus, is his omniscience is so much at play here. What he does with the woman, don't look at it as he refusing to help her. What Jesus is doing is testing her faith. So what he does is when she asks him for help, he says, paraphrasing, well, it's not me. That means it's not necessary for for me to give you the food that's meant for the lost sheep of Israel. Those are the ones that I must go to first. Now you have to understand that doing this pericope, he's already been to the lost house sheep of Israel, but they rejected him, so now he's coming to the Gentile nation. Only his disciples don't know this. But here it is, she's asking him for help, and Jesus says, no, it's not necessary. I have come to the lost house of the sheep of Israel, and then I'm coming to you. But guess what she did? She didn't wait on Jesus to come to her. She went to him. And a lot of times in our situations and circumstances, we don't need to wait when someone says wait. We need to come directly to Jesus. We don't let anybody stop us from coming to Christ. You can come to Christ through prayer and supplication to him and ask him to deal with your situation. You, how many of you know you can cast your cares upon him, because the Bible says he cares for you. And so you have to understand that nobody should deter you from coming to where Jesus is. Look at this woman. Look at Jesus stretching her faith. What he says to her is that you are a dog, not in the derogatory sense, but he plays on a wordplay here. He says, they call you dogs. The Jews calls you dog. Why are you bothering me? And look how she turns it around. He's using the derogatory term, the test of faith, and see just how strong her faith is. And she turns it around and she says, yeah, Lord. But the pet dog, the pet animal, not the dog that they call me, but the pet dog eat from the master table the crumbs that fall from the table, and they are so great. Let me explain that table. She's telling God that his table is so big and so full of blessings that anything that come off of his table is all right for her. What's on the table? Well, I'm glad you asked me what's on the table. There's joy on the table. There's forgiveness on the table. There's healing power on the table. There's love on the table. There is longevity and lifelong lasting on the table. And that's why she's so full. She said, yeah, Lord, you got so much, I would just be satisfied with the crumb. And how many of you know that you can get a crumb from Jesus? That woman that had the issue of blood 12 long years, all she got from Jesus was a crumb. Where was the crumb? On the hem of his garment. She says, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. A crumb from Jesus is better than any crumb you'd ever get. And that's why she says, I'll be happy with the crumb. Don't you know that God pinches us off crumbs every day? We're looking at part of it. Sunshine, that's a crumb from heaven above. Life, that's a crumb from heaven above. Strength, that's something from above, from God. And so we need to understand where this woman is coming from. She's not offended by what Jesus says. It makes her more persistent to ask for help. Sometimes, my dear heart, we turn and run from God too quickly. We give up too quickly. We stop asking him about helping us. Be persistent in your prayers. Be persistent in your approach. Persistency is what paid off with this woman. She did not worry about what they thought of her. This is not Jesus thinking of it. He's telling her through a dialogue of what the Jews call her. But you notice one thing I like about this woman and the strength? She did not let that deter her from getting help of what she needed. And I think that's where we need to build our nest right there, is that don't let anybody deter you from getting help from Jesus Christ, because a lot of times folk don't want to see you prosper. Let me tell you something. Jesus also hid. Put a little note here. Look how Jesus stretches this dialogue between her, knowing all the time that she was strong of faith, but he wanted to test it. Every now and then, when you're in dialogue with a person, the more you talk to a person, the more you can find out about them. Amen, life. Sometimes the best way to learn about somebody is just let them talk. Amen, life. And so Jesus is letting her talk. He knows her need. He knows that she has faith. He's looking at the degree of faith, and she is not deterred by coming to him. And look what Jesus said. Even after the disciples say, Master sent her away. Now, theological studies say that she worshiped him because in the text, it says that she came and fell down and worshiped him. Guess what? Lord, I don't know what you're going to do for me. I'm paraphrasing this, but guess what? Whatever you give, I'll be happy with the crumbs. I'll be happy if you just straighten her up and let her live. I'll be happy if she just be relieved of this demon spirit. I'll just be happy that if we can get some rest that night. Lord, just throw me a crumb. How many of you know that God has thrown you a crumb throughout your life when your life was not right with God? God feeds us even when our spirit is not right. God does not turn us away. And so we need to be like this woman. We need to be strong. We need to come and stay there and worship him until you get an answer. How many of us have given up? I had one time, one of the parishioners asked me, say, how many times should I ask God for a favor? I said, as many times you think of it. You cannot worry God. You can't hurry God, but you sure can't worry. So every day your prayer is to get some help for somebody through this pandemic. Lord, help me. Help me to help somebody else. This morning on the news, they had a little child, 4 or 5 years old, that started a book club to help folk who could not get out and get books at the library. This is a 5 or 6 year old child who is throwing crumbs around the Houston area that's helping other folk along the way. And you can't tell me that as much as what God has blessed us with through the years, we can't throw somebody a crumb. We can't help somebody along the way. God forbid that we would hold on to the substance that God has blessed us with. We need to help. When someone asked us, I remember as a child, Sister Alice Johnson, as a child, when we wanted to go somewhere, normally my dad, I had to ask him about 2 weeks in advance. He was kind of tight. You had to really start two weeks in advance to ask him for some money. My mother used to go in about a day and just worry her all day. Mama, I need $15. Mama, I want to go out with my friends. Mama, I need $15. And she said, boy, I don't have no $15. You must think money grow on trees. I said, no, Mama, I just need the $15. And I would worry her. Mama, all the rest of the kids are going to be there. I'm not going to be there. And finally, she would open up this little handkerchief out of here. You know where here is. And she would pull that handkerchief out, and she would pull out $10. Not $15, what I asked for. But she would put out $10, and she'd say, here, boy, just get out of my face. You have to be persistent with God for him to give you a crumb. I didn't get the $15, but she gave me a crumb. She gave me what I needed in order to be with a friend. Somebody ought to praise God right there. God will give you what you need, but all the time he does not give you what you want. And so we have to be patient with God. Just like an earthly mother, father that will give us things, guess what? We need to understand that this woman has tenacity to go to Jesus despite she's going to be talked about. Don't worry about how you praise God. Don't worry how you pray to God on your job. How you read your Bible, because guess what? Everybody gonna talk about you. But guess what? When things get tough for them, guess who they gonna come to? Guess who they gonna ask, how do you make it over? How do you make it through the loss of a loved one? How did you get through all of that? That you're the person that they gonna come to. But a lot of times they'll talk about you. All you talk about is Jesus. Honey, be like Shouting Johnny. I tell you what you do. Just hold my mule while I'll praise him all by myself. And here it is, that this woman has the tenacity to go to Jesus and ask him for help. And here it is, here's the kicker. He says, I am not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and what? Worshiped him, saying, Lord, help me. You saw the help me in the beginning, and now you see the help me again. She is persistent. How many of you know what persistence is? That means that you go back to God every day, every hour that it comes on your heart, leave it there. And guess what? This woman did not take her problems back from the Lord. When we take them to Jesus, leave them there. It cannot be fixed when it's in our hands. But if we give it to God, God can fix it in his time. Amen? So we need to make sure that when we go to God, we go, number one, in faith. We go trusting in God. And we leave it there until we get an answer. We need to understand that Jesus is saying it's not necessary to take the children's bread and cast it to the dog. The bread was not a literal bread. It was the spirit, the bread of life that Jesus was talking about that he had brought to the lost sheep of Israel. And what did they do? They rejected him and his word. Amen. Like, so guess what? Like I told you, he's all is on his way to bring it to the Gentiles. You remember on his way to the cross, he told them that I must go through Samaria. John chapter 4. And guess what? This woman that Jesus met at the well, here again, you see the presence of mind that Jesus has. He's omniscient, and every now and then, you've got to let show, or you've got to be honest with who you are when you come to God. Guess what? This woman comes to God and Jesus at the well, and he no doubt greeted her, and she said, you know, what business does a Jew have with a Samaritan? And Jesus said, go call your husband. She says, I don't have a husband. He said, you said right. He said, you've had five, and the one you with is not yours. So she did not let that deter her life of what she had been and what she had done from with a dialogue with Jesus. Here again, and I'm stressing this point, don't let your past determine your future with Jesus Christ. No matter what we've been, we might be all sanctimonious now, we might be all holier than thou now, but we didn't start out that way. Before we came to the church and got with James, Peter, John, and the different disciples, Matthew and Mark, we had some friends out there that we daily dealt with. It was Boom Farm Apple Wine and MD 2020 and Thunderbird and Supreme 7 until we found the Lord. So don't let nobody tell you that they've been holy all their life. When you come to God, you don't have to put on a faith. This woman did not put on a faith atmosphere. She just said, Lord, I need you. And that's what we have to do. We have to be honest with ourselves. Lord, I'm going for help. If you go to a doctor, and I'm almost through with this, if you go to a doctor and he asks you what's wrong, and you don't tell him every part of your issue, he really can't help you fully. You have to be honest with the doctor. Lord, I got a pain here, I got a pain there, I haven't been feeling good. I get up and it seems like to me I'm weaker than dishwater, and maybe he can run the test necessary. But if you go in and he asks you how you're doing and you say, I'm all right, well, why are you here? You need to understand that this woman is here to get some help from Christ. She is not worried about him, what he says to her. She's worried about his health. Because in the previous part of this, in the first part of this 15th chapter, she knows that he's healing folk. She knows that he's blessing folk. And so we have to go to Jesus in order to get our blessing. Some folk think that we go to the grocery store and get our blessing. Yeah, those are blessings that God allows us to have the substance in order to buy what we need. But it's because of God that we go to get the necessary blessing, and that is a spirit of living. And so we have to understand, and I like what she said, yet the dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee, even as thou wilt. Now, what would have happened if she'd have listened to the disciples? Study says that they might have been asking for Jesus to hurry up and bless her and send her on her way. But that's not what I read. What I read in the text and through study is that they did not want to be bothered with her as they were on their way to a destination. You got to watch church folk. Some church folk will turn your life around and cause you not to praise God. Don't ever let that happen. You praise God no matter where you are and whatever your circumstances are, you praise God. Remember again back in John 4, the woman at the well, the disciples told, Lord, you ought not be talking to her. Remember blind Bartimaeus? Lord, look, don't be listening to blind Bartimaeus. You have to understand that God will listen to you when you talk to him. And don't be worried about what's going on around you, what other folks say. You be persistent with God. God, I need you right now. A lot of times when we go into the doctor's office, Lord, I need you right about now. I need you to walk with me and talk with me and tell me that you're going to take care of me. You promised me that you would never leave me alone. Every now and then, you need to have a real conversation with God Almighty. Not just when it's necessary, but when we need help, we need to go to Dr. Jesus. Not only will Dr. Jesus help us, but he will stretch our faith. And he will test our faith sometimes. You have to understand that we got a call the other day, that someone who's going through an issue found out it wasn't as serious as what she thought it was when she first was diagnosed with it. And God is an awesome God. The thing of the matter is that he will take care of us if we let him. Now, it's like anything else. If God writes you a prescription and helps you out of your situation, then you need to thank him and move on forward. Amen? If a doctor writes you a prescription, it's not going to do you any good if you don't take it. So you need to take it. God will fix it. And let me warn you of something. When you ask God to fix it, let him fix it. Don't get in his way. Because he's not going to fix it. Lord, just relieve a little bit of the pain and I can deal with the rest of it. No. Let him fix the entire problem that you're dealing with and give him time to fix it. Amen? Give him time to fix it. Look what he says after the dialogue. Oh, what faith. How is your faith today? Are you willing to stick it out? This pandemic is testing everybody. Even if you're sound mind and body, this stuff is testing us because we don't know. If we go somewhere to the store or wherever, you could bring it back home to a loved one. Hadn't God been good? That we know that God has protected us. And we know that we've been around folk who have been infected, who was, you need to understand that God is protecting you right now, and you need to keep the trust up. You need to keep the faith in God. And whatever you have, take it to God. How can we take it to God? We take it to him in prayer. We take it to him in supplication. And don't let anybody stop you from praising God, from worshiping God, falling down and worshiping him. Get up in the morning, worship him, whether it be morning, noonday, or night. Don't let anybody stop you. If they call you while you're praying, just push that little button and say, I can't talk right now. You're talking with God. And while you're talking with God, be specific on what you need. Not only was this woman persistent, she was specific. My daughter needs healing. And yes. So be specific when you come to God. Yeah. Ask him for what you want. He said, if you ask anything in my name, it'll be granted. Now, you do have to understand that you have to accept what God fixed for you. Amen? Yeah. You cannot turn around and say, Lord, I don't like that one. You need to remove that one, fix it for me another way. You have to accept what he does for you. And this woman accepted what God, and she got a standing ovation. Old woman, he probably no doubt turned to the disciples and said, how great a faith. This woman has the faith that Jesus can help her. The disciples telling her to move on. So everybody don't pray at the same faith, right? So when somebody says, you don't need to pray that long, just keep on praying. When somebody says,
you don't need to shout that way, just keep on shouting. When they're sitting next to you and they feel that they're scooting over, just shout the more and wave your hands and stomp your feet, and hopefully they'll move to another road. Tell your neighbor that I'm not going to let anybody stop me now. God has brought me too far for me to stop praising him right about now. So I'm going to praise him no matter where I am. I got a good testimony the other day from a wife, and she's in the store. He was talking to somebody else, and a lady stepping around said, "Can you pray for me?" And they had a prayer vigil right there. That's what you do when you are showing that God has blessed you. You bless somebody else. You do know your prayers work as much, don't you? We can pray for one another. So don't stop praying for me. Don't stop praying for me. Pray for me. Pray seriously for me and my family and everybody at this Bell Zion Church, because the prayers of the righteous availeth much. This woman need to be remembered, because she did not let anybody deter her, even the disciples. She kept walking with Jesus. If you keep walking with Jesus, I tell you what, you'll be happy with the crumbs that fall from the table. God bless you. We're at this time to extend the privilege of the church, whether you're coming by letter, restoration, a candidate for baptism. Our motto is, whosoever will, let them come, and they need to come while the blood is running warm in their veins. So come on, officers, and extend the privilege of the church. We thank you again, visitors. If you have no church home, this is a time that you can come and join up with this little prayer band that meets from time to time on the big old oak tree. Amen, and praise God. So at this time, we will extend that privilege. Amen. Amen. How many know that there's nobody like the Lord? Amen. Amen. Can't nobody do you like Jesus. We thank you. It is ours to extend, yours to accept or reject. I want to thank our officers for coming and blessing us and opening up the doors of the church. Amen. Right now, before we dismiss, again, we want to thank all of our visitors for coming today. We thank God for this day again. We want to pray for all of our children. How many of you have got children or grandchildren that's starting back to school tomorrow? Amen, amen. We're going to pray for them.
we're going to ask God's protection around them because we don't know what's all going on, but we know God knows. Amen. And so some of the people that are sending our children back to school don't care. So guess what? We're going to have to put them in the hands of God.
Yeah.
And we're going to have to build that community that's handling our children, teachers as well, how to handle this pandemic. Amen. And still teach. So right now, Heavenly Father, we just want to cover all of your children, all of your grandchildren, all of the teachers and instructors that are going to be in the schools this week or wherever they might be. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this day, and we know that you've got the whole world in your hand. We know, Heavenly Father, that you're able to take care of all of us. So right now, Lord, we're just making a petition on all of your teachers, whether they're teaching virtually or they're teaching in person. We just ask that you would just build a fence around our children, and Heavenly Father, protect them from this virus, protect them from predators, protect them, Heavenly Father, from anybody that would want to do them harm. Help them to learn and concentrate on their learning. Let them know that they can always come to you in prayer. And dear Heavenly Father, we just pray that the parents of these children, the grandparents of these children will, this is an opportunity since they took prayer out of school to put it back in school. And dear Heavenly Father, we just ask that they would teach them some Bible lessons along the way so that they will not depart from your word, that they will stay in your way. We pray for our college students as well, dear Heavenly Father, and all the professors from coast to coast, that you might endow them with a sense of mind that they can do whatever they do or whatever they can to keep our children safe. Lord, you're entrusting us with our children. We have to entrust them with other folk. So we know that you're able to keep them and you can do everything but fail. And we just pray in Jesus' name, amen. Okay. God bless you. All right, do we have any other announcements? I did have a card from Brother Carr on the passing of his brother. I did bring it last week, but he was just saying thank you for the love, for the wonderful flower that we sent him during his time of bereavement. And we just thank God for all of you. If that be nothing else, Sister Doris? All right. God bless you. May the grace of God and the sweet dominion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us from this time, henceforth, and forevermore. And they all humped and said, amen. God bless you. You are excused. See you Thursday on Bible study.